BPC157. Is this really what it seems? A miracle agent? I don't know. We have to get into this. So this has been out there as one of those peptides for many years on the bro science blogs. It's making its way into anti-aging rejuvenation doctors. So I have to look at this. And I've had experience with it anecdotally with a bunch of patients. So right off the bat, what actually is this? It's a pentadecapeptide, it's called BPC, which stands for Body Protection Compound 157. So it's a partial sequenced amino acid complex of 15 amino acids. It's actually from human gastric juice, which is amazing itself. That's where they found this. And it has protective qualities from the aspect of being in the gut with acid, so it's protective to the GI tract. Now, this stuff seems to be amazing when it's injected or taken orally through other systems in the body, as it enhances healing systemically. It's been purported to be this amazing overall systemic healing agent. Most importantly, musculoskeletal on muscles, tendons, also on the nervous system. Also said to be anti-inflammatory, and it says to be aiding in healing from wound healing, also status post cortico injection, steroid injections, which people know you got a bad shoulder or a knee, they inject corticosteroids in there, and that could help reduce the pain, but it could damage the tissue. It also aids in healing for non-steroidal anti-inflammatory GI ulcers, which is a problem in the world for people. And also other GI issues, inflammatory bowel disease, anyone with Crohn's or ulcerative colitis, seems like this stuff will be a no-brainer. What's going on? What's the mechanism of action of this incredible agent? Now, the data on this thing is very limited, so I found two studies, because it's really more rat studies and non-human studies. So the first one is, way back, the Journal of Applied Physiology, 1985, the promoting effects of pentadecapeptide, BPC-157, on tendon healing involving tendon growth, cell survival, and cell migration. Number one. Next one was current neuropharmacology. These are real peer-reviewed medical journal articles. This was from 2016, and this is brain-gut axis and pentadecapeptide. Peptide BPC-157, theoretical and practical implications. So when they look at the concept of mechanism of action, there's really about three things that comes up. That it increases blood flow directly to the tissue via something called angiogenesis, where it actually grows and rehabilitates actually capillary tissue. It grows blood vessels. That's interesting itself, brings increased blood flow. Also, it stimulates GH and other types of anabolic receptors. Not anabolic steroid, androgenic. It's anabolic receptors. The body heals itself through these receptors. There's some upregulation and stimulation on those itself. Also, via this pathway of stimulation, there's increase in collagen synthesis and production. So, right there, this is incredible. Does it work? What do we hear about it? You do hear people anecdotally saying that they have less pain. And if you have massive injuries, like full detached rotator cuffs and things, it's not going to work. But can it work for someone that has some age-related tendon issues or overtraining, heart training? I would love this stuff. Definitely going to look into this stuff. And with that said, there's no studies really apart from these minimal animal rat studies. And then you have all these other guys trying to promote it to sell it. Please, let's get anecdotes. This is the channel. This is why I'm here. I want to hear from everyone in the world about BPC-157. What does it do? Has it helped you? What were your doses? We got to get it out. We're here for education and truth. I want to hear, because I really don't know about it. It's very minimal. I think this is going to be big. It's coming out there. It's orally, it's injections. Let's hear about what you've done, all your experiences. Now, let's go right to the side effects. So, side effects, anecdotally, is going to be minimal. So, the great thing about this, theoretically, is that there's really no side effects. If you read into it, and I did my research, I watched tons of videos, I've talked to all my patients about it over the years, of course, and I compiled my thoughts, and I looked at the research, did all my research online, like anyone else would do. Number one side effect is, if it's taken intramuscularly in the injection site, like any injection, it could have redness or swelling or pain. So that's really not such a systemic issue. Let's talk about the real systemic issues as far as side effects. Number one, side effects, secondary to the stimulation of growth in your body, like growth hormone. And the concern about long-term growth hormone use, or IGF, or anything that grows. Number one is cancer. Is it gonna stimulate? Do you have an underlying malignancy? Again, it's gonna be skin malignancy, melanoma. Do you have a GI, a brain tumor? People have these things, colon cancer, prostate cancer, pancreatic cancer. I'm a physician, I see these things. So if you have that underlying and you're injecting, taking this agent and you're upregulating stimulation of growth, uncontrolled cell growth is cancer. Number one, we have no idea. I'm not for this or against it. I'd actually love to use it. Let's see if it works over the years. There's no studies, so what are we gonna do about this? Now, next is the effect on angiogenesis. It affects the blood vessels. So if you think about it, it appears, and anecdotally I've seen, there's vascular effects. What does that mean, vascular? That's on the blood pressure, on the blood vessels. So it's said to lower blood pressure. Well, if you're on blood pressure medicine and you take this, can you lower your blood pressure? That's not always a great thing because you're gonna get dizzy. Maybe you could fall. Maybe you're driving the car and you fall. Maybe you're lifting heavy. Your blood pressure tanks. You're really dizzy with a lot of weight in your back. That's gonna be very bad. I hear these things every day when I'm just treating my basic patients with blood pressure medicine. You gotta be careful. So vascular effects and labile hypertension, labile blood pressure going up and down, labile up and down. It's not stable, dizziness. Next, toxicity, systemic toxicity on your organs, liver, kidney, and the heart. We just don't know. I don't see that it's mediating through any system itself, like the kidney, the liver. There's no pharmacology on it that I could read, so we just don't know. Can't just say it's safe. There's going to be no studies on it. Now, the effects that I'm worrying about that I've heard is palpitations and that nervousness and the palpitations. So if you have an underlying arrhythmia, if you have a supraventricular arrhythmia, atrial fibrillation, or a flutter, which millions of people have, I see it all the time, usually on older people, but sometimes young guys have this. Or ventricular arrhythmias, which those are absolutely deadly, and I see those too, very rare though, of course. Could this interact and worsen that arrhythmia? Could it also interact with medications? Amiodarone, these are antiarrhythmic drugs, beta blockers, calcium channel blockers, blood pressure medicines, diuretics, anticoagulation medicines, Coumadin, Xarelto, Eliquis, Heparin. I have patients on all this stuff because you have to integrate all these aspects of medicine into a real person that's on other medicines. So, and what's the dose? I don't know, it looks like 400 micrograms to 1,000 micrograms a day. How long do you take it? Do you take it for a cycle like steroids where it's a month or 6 weeks and you stop? What if it's working great and you stop? Do you have a rebound in your pain? Do you have a rebound in your worsening inflammation or your damage in your system? I just don't know. So with that said, please be careful. This is the world of today. Everything's on the internet. Everyone's doing their research. Doctors are not in this because doctors are overloaded and busy. I'm the doc for testosterone, guys in testosterone, guys on steroids to trust. This is huge. This is one of these peptides for healing. Seems like it could be part of the armamentarium to help you. I would use anything that's tried and true. Everything's gonna have side effects. I will use anything for my patients, for you in the world to heal and to help. But you have to remember, there's always going to be side effects. So you want to be conservative and careful. Let's get the comments, guys. Let's get it go. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope it helps.